The January 15, 2022 eruption of the previously little-known Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha'apai volcano has likely forever changed the world of volcanology. Just like during Pele's 1902 eruption and the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens, obvious warning signs which in hindsight now seem obvious of the disaster were seemingly missed as the associated dangers were previously unknown to science. Whereas at Pele, the warning sign was a highly pressurized incandescent eruption plume that marked a change in the nature of the eruption, at Mount St. Helens it was the growth of a several hundred foot high bulge. And at Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha'apai, a moderately sized eruption on January 14th removed a section of the island, allowing for seawater to infiltrate the volcano's magma conduit. Although this was the first since modern geology was created, very similar eruptions have also occurred in the past 11,650 years that destroyed similarly large islands and eruptions which were somewhat similar to Hunga Tonga's now infamous eruption. For example, around 700 BCE, a large island existed at Iwo Jima. Then, a powerful volcanic eruption occurred, destroying it and perhaps forming a section of the volcano's mostly submerged several-mile-wide caldera. Since then, new volcanism has occurred, and this has been significantly uplifted by more than 100 meters. What was previously a beach in 1950 is now 14 meters or 46 feet above sea level. This island will most likely one day also be destroyed in a catastrophic eruption in a manner that resembles Hunga Tonga's event. However, Iwo Jima is not the only submarine caldera or island to be destroyed in recent times. There is also the 1650 eruption of the Kolumbo volcano in Greece, which sent destructive pyroclastic flows and tsunamis all the way to the island of Santorini. Or Krakatau, which produced caldera-forming eruptions in 540 and 1883. Although we are still trying to understand the circumstances which can create a repeat eruption similar to Hunga Tonga on January 15th, I have created two criteria to help identify volcanoes which serve as candidates for similar future eruptions. First, it must be a submarine volcano with a potential eruption vent at a depth of shallower than 200 meters or less than 200 meters above sea level. Second, it must have a several kilometer wide pre-existing caldera, preferentially one which formed in the last 10,000 years. This may seem self-explanatory, but volcanoes with a history of collapse events and caldera-forming eruptions are more likely to produce similar repeat events in the future. Thus, I have compiled a list of 16 volcanoes which largely fit this description and could in the next several thousand years produce another caldera-forming eruption that either deepens the existing caldera, forms a new one, or destroys most of an island if one exists. I have listed these at the top which I deem most likely to produce a similar future event, while volcanoes at the bottom are least likely to produce an eruption. Although this may simply be due to the fact of how thoroughly mapped a section of the Pacific Ocean is, eight of these entries are located in a chain of activity between New Zealand, Tonga, and Fiji. These include both the Tofua and Niuafo'ou volcanoes, as these contain visible shallow calderas which cause the island to have the appearance of a ring. I have included Hunga Tonga on this list as it was suggested that the volcano does not always produce a single caldera-forming eruption every 1,000 years, but rather a series of large, closely spaced eruptions. I included the Krakatoa volcano as not only has it produced two Holocene caldera-forming eruptions, but its 1883 eruption was the closest eruption in terms of what was observed to Hunga Tonga's eruption. I have also included both Kolumbo and Santorini in Greece, the submarine Kuwei caldera in Vanuatu, two volcanoes in the Northern Mariana Islands, Iwo Jima, and the Kikai volcano. Of course, it is difficult to definitively determine which of these volcanoes produce another similar eruption in the next 10,000 years. This list is largely speculative, so governments and people in the region can hypothetically prepare for an unlikely worst-case scenario. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron or YouTube member of this channel.